The numbers stick to what we broke yesterday. This is where all the 19 MLAs are right now holed up. There are three luxury villas inside this prestige golf shire where they have been stayed put. In fact, the state BJP here had been very tight-lipped about this entire operation, and media was just to do some guesswork. But we nailed this story. Prestige Golf Shire is where these MLAs have been staying for the last 3 days, Rishabh. This is what sources inside the resort told us, that they have been staying here in these three villas at Prestige Golf Shire for the last 3 days. So they came here, about nine of them have come 3 days ago, and yesterday around 10 of them have joined. So altogether there are 19 of them. This is what we have found out, and in fact we were there inside the resort, and we saw these MLAs watching news developments as and when it's unfolding, and they're all together at the clubhouse watching news. And Prestige Golf Shire, this is about 45 kilometers from Bengaluru. This is about 10 kilometers from Nandi Hills, very close to the Bangalore International Airport, and they have been hold up here right behind me, Prestige Golf Shire. You can see all there is security all round. Any vehicle which has to pass through has to go through at least 3 to 4 security rings there. CCB and local police have also been deployed here in Mufti. They are in civil dresses, and inside too there are bouncers who are keeping an eagle eye on the movement of these MLAs. They're not letting them go anywhere. They're circling them wherever they move. In fact, those pictures were what I sent you, those 19 of them showing those resignation letters posing next to the golf course there. Even there, there is security men all around. So, a very close eye is being kept on these MLAs. And we, in fact, overheard these MLAs discussing Madhya Pradesh politics. Rapid developments that have been unfolding in Delhi, they're all queued into those news developments. But their stay here is indefinite, Rishabh. That much is very much clear, because these are three villas which has been hired by the BJP here. Arvind Limmavali is the man. In fact, there was a lot of smoke screen as far as their location is concerned. But at around 11:30 is when we'll nail this story, that they are in fact here in Bengaluru. Till yesterday, only the fight manifest was there in our hands. And now their locations, their live locations have been nailed by us, and they are very much there inside all those MPs who have defected from the Congress party. Back to you.
Okay. There is a photograph on your screen which I was showing you a short while ago. There are several others. Eventually, my producers will get their ducks in a row. Megha, Gauri, Shivangi, Pankaj will all figure out what they're doing and quickly get all this put on the screen like it should be. Jayaprakash, 19 it is. The action stations have, of course, shifted somewhat significantly to Delhi. Now, my quick question to you is, what is the reverberation of this in Karnataka where you're standing, Jayaprakash? Because there has been so much sulking, disgruntlement being led from the top by Rahul Gandhi himself, quit as Congress president, does not want to take charge once again. And now this is now turning into consequences. Jyotiraditya Scindia, one of the closest associates of Rahul Gandhi, is now gone. He's gone. He's joined the BJP. The people he was abusing and insulting in Lok Sabha hardly 18 months ago. Now, obviously, is there a realization in the Congress now that if they don't get their game sorted now between this old guard, new guard, that others could follow?
Well, Rishabh, I mean, sadly, it doesn't reflect. And in fact, one of the reasons I could say here is, if we media could crack this place where these MLAs have been holed up, what was the state Congress doing? In fact, K.C. Venugopal reached out to Siddaramaiah, Dinesh Gundarao, as well as D.K. Shukumar, their man for all reasons and all seasons, the true blue congressman, the troubleshooter. Nobody bothered to, in fact, find out whether these MLAs were, in fact, staying in Bengaluru or whether they were here. It is all the media contingency which has rushed to this spot now. As far as state Congress is concerned, it is in tatters. There is no doubt about that. The resignation letters have been sent by Siddaramaiah and Dinesh Gundarao. There is no replacements that have happened. All important budget session took place. Yediyurappa presented his 7th budget, but there is no opposition voice at all. So as far as Congress is concerned, state Congress is concerned, it is in tatters, and it is veered off the track, you can easily say. But what is reflecting in Delhi should be a reminder lecture or a lesson to the state dispensation here, the Congress party especially, to in fact pull up their socks and fight united. But I don't see it happening. But what we are right now seeing is another government, like how the Congress
is. I'm drawing the assumption from what you were suggesting and what we've been showing, Jay Prakash, that the letter that these MLAs are photographing themselves with is their resignation letter. Are they resigning as MLAs from the Congress party? It looks like a Congress letterhead. What are they resigning from?
They are resigning from the positions that they hold, the MLAs, and these resignation letters are addressed to the Speaker, and soon these letters will be handed over to the Speaker, and then if the resignation letters are not accepted, then they will have to go in person to Bhopal. That's the reason maybe why they are made to stay very close to the airport. It's about a 20 minutes drive from this particular place. So same scenes being played out. We saw how JDS and Congress MLAs displayed the resignation letters, the pictures in the Mumbai hotels on not one, two, but three occasions. And the last one is when they were shifted out to an undisclosed location. It was a farmhouse in a nondescript area somewhere very close to Mumbai. So these scenes are happening right now here at the Prestige Golf Share, and this is going to be the epicenter of all the rebellion as far as Madhya Pradesh government is concerned. More MLAs are expected to join them is what our sources do tell us. But as of now, easily we could count about 14 of them hanging around together at the clubhouse where they were following all the news developments on the television.
Okay, so the action is going to shift to Delhi. Is there any still rumor, Shivangi, as we are fiddling around with this, of course you're mucking it up on air as we speak. Is there any rumor, any talk now, you were discussing this with me late last night, JP, that there might be more people flying in, or is there now no need? If the wind has shifted into Bhopal, so be it, that this 38 that we're talking about, double the figure, is no longer relevant.
Well, absolutely. I mean, if you talk about the numbers, everything boils down to a number. They need less than about 7 or 8 to topple the government, but comfortably they are sitting at the number 19. 19 is the number of MLAs who are here. So easily the fortunes have tilted in favor of the BJP, you could say, and it's just a matter of days, or rather the processes that are involved to pull down this government, that is going to be in play next. And these are the things which will be discussed as far as the BJP is concerned. But as far as Congress is concerned, well, as I mentioned earlier, the less number of MLAs from the Congress party in the assembly, that will only benefit the BJP and not the Congress.
As I try to find my microphone, wait a second. JP, the question then becomes that are there others going to follow? Now, you've been mentioning that between a Siddaramaiah, who's certainly not new guard, but at the same time, he's a former JDS man who joined the Congress. He served as a Congress chief minister, so I can't call him new guard, but DK Shivkumar is certainly hoping to be new guard. Are any of these people wondering, A, what the heck is going on, and B, whether they are better to find homes in their own parties, smaller parties, elsewhere? Because now, right now, there is a lot of talk going on the fate of a Sachin Pilot or a fate of a Milind Deora and many others.